2021 marked the return of sports across the Mountain East Conference and Concord University, and what a year of success it was for the Mountain Lions. From conference champions to historic feats and records being broken, and from unforgettable games to double-digit All-Americans, we look back at the best of 2021 for Concord Athletics.
Number 10. From the time the 2020 sports calendar was canceled March 12th to the time of the return of sports at Concord, 301 long days passed. Men's and women's basketball restarted the action in January. Volleyball followed in February, and then busy months of March and April followed with all 16 sports at Concord competing at virtually the same time. Not only did 2021 mark the return of sports, but it also paved the way for new turf on the football field, artificial surfaces on the baseball and softball field for the first time, and new look to Christy Cox Court inside the Carter Center.
Number 9. Longtime men's soccer coach Steve Baird announced his retirement after a 23-year run at Concord, guiding the men's team and, for a time, the women's team in Athens. Another longtime veteran of Concord, Kenny Osborne, picked up win 300 in his illustrious career at the start of the 2021-22 season for the women's basketball team. And a familiar face returned to Concord as former All-American softball catcher Alyssa Morris returned to her alma mater in August. Morris will begin her first season on the diamond as the head coach of the Concord softball program in the spring of 2022.
I love the small school atmosphere. You know, it's just, it's more of a home to me and a family-like thing that drew me back. Just knowing that the success of the program and the traditions that have been here for the past 10 years, and I get to be a part of that again, it's such a privilege, and it's very, very exciting.
Number 8. The women's cross-country team at Concord has accomplished several first-time feats under head coach Mike Cox. At the beginning of November, Cox's top two runners, Hannah Altizer and Emily Wallace, became the first all-region cross-country athletes in program history, something Cox has been chasing for nearly 20 years at Concord. The tandem finished in the top 20 of Atlantic Regional Championship to set the bar higher ahead of the 2022 track season.
Number 7. The number of unforgettable games for the Mountain Lions across all sports over the past year number in the dozens, but perhaps the most exciting one was on the hardwood on the first day of March. Concord men's basketball proved what March Madness is all about. In the first round of the MEC tournament inside the Carter Center, Concord had to withstand 13 lead changes and 14 ties to finally survive and advance in double overtime against Davis and Elkins. Ethan Heller put together one of his best games in a CU jersey with 28 points, and Brandon Kennedy netted another 14 points in the 107-100 win.
Number 6. Athens became known as a place where nationally ranked teams could not escape with a win regardless of sport. A total of 4 nationally ranked teams came onto campus and none left with a win. Men's basketball started the run by knocking off nationally ranked number 4 West Liberty on the hardwood. The women's basketball team held up their end of the bargain by defeating 2 nationally ranked teams, Charleston and Glenville State, during the month of February. And baseball concluded the run by beating a nationally ranked Charleston baseball team not once or twice, but 3 times.
Number 5. 2021 marked the season where Concord softball saw 2 key individual program records fall. It began with Jenna Witt, a multi-year all-region performer and 2018 All-American, becoming the all-time hits queen for the program. And already the owner of the single-season strikeout record, Courtney Schoolcraft broke the career strikeout record.
You're unrelated to the game currently. It's unrelated to play. Here's a 2-2 and a swing and a miss, and Courtney Schoolcraft
doing so in just a little over 2 years of work. Witt finished her outstanding career with 255 career hits, one of 3 career records broken for Witt. For Schoolcraft, she racked up 284 career strikeouts.
Number 4. A slow start of the 2021 season made a conference tournament appearance for the Concord baseball team seem like a dream. But not only did CU walk off on the final day of the regular season to clinch an MEC tournament bid, the Mountain Lions stormed their way to a championship game appearance. Between timely hitting and shutdown pitching provided on the mound by Trent Abernathy, Andrew Neff, and Eddie Blake, Concord started the conference postseason at 3-0. The run, however, would end in the title game against West Virginia State.
Number 3. 2021 will always be remembered as the year of the All-American at Concord. 6 different programs had 11 student-athletes recognized as All-Americans on the field, academic All-Americans off of it, or in some cases, both. JT Turner of the Concord football team became an academic All-American for a third time. Wide receiver Tywan Pierce was recognized as a second-team All-American for his play on the field, the football program's first All-American in 4 years. Leah Foster and Yasmin Mosby of the women's soccer team joined Turner as a multiple-time academic All-American, and Jason Weitzel kept his career both an All-American on the track and an academic All-American in the classroom. But that wasn't it. Riley Fitzwater, women's basketball, and Anthony Stalen, baseball, were honored as All-Americans for their performance and work in the classroom. Isaac Prather backed up an All-American track season with an All-American cross-country campaign. And a total of 6 women's soccer players, Foster, Mosby, Morgan Carmichael, Zoe Belding, and Courtney Smith, were either All-Americans on the field or academic All-Americans off of it.
Number 2. Led by Prather, his brother Preston, senior Cedric Drennan, and freshman Logan Dukelly, men's cross-country made its second appearance at the NCAA Division II National Championship in program history in November. The Mountain Lions overcame a tough field at the regional meet and put the aforementioned 4 runners in the top 30 to secure its first berth in the national meet since the historic 2016 season. Concord proved it belonged among the nation's best with 27th place finish in Tampa, Florida.
Number 1. Speaking of the nation's best, the number 1 slot goes to one of Division II's top women's soccer programs. Guided by the Atlantic Regional Coach of the Year, Luke Duffy, 2021 was one for the ages for women's soccer. After falling short in the spring 2021 MEC Championship game, the Mountain Lions came back on a mission in the fall. First came an MEC South Division title, then an MEC Championship, but what followed was history-making. A chance to host NCAA tournament games, the program's first NCAA tournament win in Victory over Mercyhurst, a berth into the Sweet 16 by defeating Bloomsburg, and the first regional title in program history with a win over Westchester, and just the 3rd regional title for Concord Athletics overall. A chance at a Final Four came up just short in the Elite Eight against the St. Rose. We hope you've enjoyed the best of 2021 at Concord. The bar has been set high for the next calendar year. Here's to a great and successful 2022.